China continues to flex its muscle in the West Philippine Sea. Just a day after the water cannon and boat ramming incident near Escorta Shoal, about seven Chinese vessels shadowed and surrounded two Philippine Coast Guard ships conducting resupply mission near Palawan Monday. The PCG says no untoward incident happened as they maintained radio communication with their Chinese counterpart. Just last week, China also fired flares into the path of a patrolling Philippine aircraft on two separate incidents. Manila bent on deterring any attack from China.
Let us deter an armed attack. That is the more important thing, and that is what I'm focused on doing. Everybody's too focused on armed attack. Let's make ourselves strong enough so that that does not happen.
Over a dozen followers of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy arrested following a tense standoff with authorities in Davao City. The city's mayor and the president's sister, meanwhile, slammed the operation, accusing police of using excessive force. Johnson Manabat reports.
The Davao City Police Office arrested 18 members of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ on Monday afternoon while removing a barricade along the diversion road of Davao City near Davao City Airport and KOJC compound. Before 3 p.m. Monday, the police gave Quiboloy supporters 10 minutes to peacefully leave the area to open the road to motorists. This ultimatum was ignored by KOJC members, prompting the police to give the third and last warning for the protesters to disperse. But KOJC members did not leave the road. This prompted the ground commander to instruct the anti-riot police to proceed with the dispersal. But the dispersal turned violent after KOJC members pushed back and threw chairs at the police. Other KOJC members, most of them wearing t-shirts covering their faces, threw an unknown liquid to the police.
Okay lang, trabaho lang naman namin to.
Around 4 p.m., authorities arrested 18 members of KOJC who are now facing obstruction of justice complaints.
Sabi nga natin, ayaw nating dumating tayo sa punto na magkakaroon ng sakitan. Pero what we can assure you, hindi po manggagaling sa PNP ang panggugulo. Hanggat maaari, gusto nating maging matahimik po yung dispersal.
The group's legal counsel says it will file counter charges against the police.
Amin pong hinihikayat ang PNP, and we are politely demanding from them to cease and desist from this operation because this is illegal. This has no basis under the law. Amin po sanang nire-request po si Mayor Baste Duterte to invoke his power under Section 17 of the Local Government Code of the Philippines, the General Welfare Clause.
Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte questions the police alleged use of excessive force against innocent citizens and their unauthorized occupation at the KOJC compound. He also asked the PNP how long they will stay at the KOJC property. Another legal counsel of the KOJC also criticized the PNP's operation.
Pag sinerch mo yung premises at hindi mo nakita yung tao, umalis ka na. Okay. Kung gusto mo, pulis ka naman, i-surveillance mo, maglagay ka ng mga tao sa harap. Pero for you to enter, hindi nyo nakita, di ka na umalis, hindi pwede yun naman. Sa ang planeta, legal yun.
Senator Aimee Marcos also condemned what she calls an excessive show of force, saying the deployment of 2,000 police personnel to raid the premises of an established religion is both unwarranted and unjustified. But Senate Deputy Minority Leader Risa Ontiveros blames Quiboloy, saying the situation would not have worsened if he just showed up at the Senate. She also reminded the PNP to ensure no violence is committed in the exercise of their mandate. The Commission on Human Rights urges both the police and Kingdom of Jesus Christ members to remain calm and follow the judicial process. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
While supporters of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy hold a rally in Manila demanding the resignation of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The protesters included former anti-communist task force spokesperson Lorraine Badoy and former Duterte spokesman Harry Roque. The demonstrators denounced what they said was an illegal police operation at a sacred private property of Quiboloy's religious group.
Hindi lang po ito laban ng KOJC, laban ng sambayan ng Pilipino po ito dahil kung malalabag nila ang karapatan ng KOJC na linigawan ni Bongbong Marcos para sa kanilang suporta noong eleksyon, mas lalo nilang lalabagyan ang karapatan ng mga ordinaryong Pilipino.
Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla welcomes the rescue of two alleged trafficking victims from the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound in Davao City. Police describe them as a 21-year-old man from Samar and a woman from Midsayap, Cotabato. They were rescued and placed under protection by police who served arrest warrants for Quiboloy. Secretary Remulla urged law enforcement agencies to ensure they come up with airtight cases against the traffickers of the two rescued victims. He also called on other alleged trafficking victims of Quiboloy's group to come forward. Turning now to the crackdown on POGOs, the sister and cohort of dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go, now under the custody of lawmakers. Sheila Go will be facing the Senate's probe on how her sister managed to flee the country, while Cassandra Leong will appear before the House Quad Committee investigating illegal POGOs. The two spent days at the headquarters of the National Bureau of Investigation after being deported from Indonesia. Authorities maintain their detention was illegal.
Walang warrant, walang kaso, i-detain mo sa NBI. That is arbitrary detention. Ano bang arbitrary detention? Any public officer who detains another, ha, without the legal cause? Oh, hindi ba yan? Public officer, ha, mga NBI, dinetain nila si Cassie Leong at si Sheila Guo, walang warrant, no nothing.
Walang arbitrary detention dito, remember. Ang arbitrary detention, nagraran lamang pagka may office hour. Eh, holiday tayo magmula pa nung Biyernes eh. May process na ginawa kami at pinailan namin ang charges, criminal charges, and they have undergone inquest proceedings.
Meanwhile, the location of Alice Guo is still unknown. She is believed to be staying in Indonesia and may be planning to go to other parts of Southeast Asia.
Kanina, yung mga ASEAN ambassadors na kausap ko at sabi nila naka-alerto na rin yung kanilang mga otoridad. So mahirapan siyang gumalaw ngayon sa ASEAN. Tingin ko mahuhuli siya sa Indonesia.
Two more cases of mpox detected in the Philippines. The health department says the two patients are both from Metro Manila. They are both infected by clade 2, which is considered milder compared to clade 1 variant fueling the outbreak in Africa. This comes as Quezon City's local government orders a club's closure for not cooperating with contact tracing. The club's management allegedly refused to allow epidemiology and surveillance personnel to initiate contact tracing activities. Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte called the non-cooperation a threat to the city's residents. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica.
Good morning to you and all of our audience in ANC. Currently, southwest monsoon is affecting southern Luzon and Visayas. And because of that, we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms over Metro Manila, Mimaropa, Cavite, Batangas, and Antique. For the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. We don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Veronica.